distal biceps ruptures, and three types of muscle contraction. Tendons are the connection of muscle to bone. They are a crucial component in the chain of structures that allow our skeleton to move. Their failure by tearing is fortunately somewhat rare, but it certainly happens when we push our bodies to the limits. Combat sports can certainly push our bodies to those limits, and an injury that comes up is the distal biceps rupture. MMA fighters such as Paulo Costa, Cody Garbrandt, boxer Miguel Cotto, and strongman turned boxer Eddie Hall all have had this injury. In this video, we will talk about the anatomy of the biceps muscle with a little intro to how muscles contract, how the injury occurs, what happens to you if you have the injury, and how orthopedic surgeons treat them. I'm Dr. Lucius Pomerantz, board certified orthopedic surgeon, black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and frequent repairer of this injury. So, a little bit about the anatomy. The biceps is a very noticed muscle. Many people really care how it looks, and that's fine. It also has some important function, but the most important of which may surprise you. As a refresher on some of the terms, proximal is closer to the center of the body, while distal is further away. The biceps muscle has two parts that act as one muscle, by two. There are two tendons that come down from our shoulder, one that comes from inside the shoulder joint, going to the long head, and the other that goes from the coracoid process, the short head of the biceps. You might remember these body parts discussed in my AC separation video. These tendons join as a common muscle, but then extends down across the elbow joint where a combined tendon attaches to the radial tuberosity. This is a little bump on our radius near our elbow. The radial tuberosity faces in the opposite direction of our radial styloid, which is this part of the wrist right here. The thumb going outside kind of mimics where that radial styloid is, and the radial tuberosity is facing in the opposite direction of this. So, going out this way, going this way. Now, because the bicep crosses the elbow joint, it is an important elbow flexor, though it is not the most important. That would be the brachialis. Its most important function is supination of the forearm. Think of trying to tighten a screw with a screwdriver. That's the biceps. With a pronated arm, the biceps pulls on the radial tuberosity and the radius turns into supination. When the biceps relaxes, the arm can then go into pronation. Now, a little into muscle contractions. Muscles contract in three ways. These are concentric, isometric, and eccentric. Concentric means what many of you think of was when a muscle contracts. The muscle contracts and shortens, moving the body part. Isometric contraction is when the muscles are contracting, but not actually moving. Think of this as pushing against something that cannot move. Muscles are working, but nothing's moving. Lastly, there is eccentric contractions. This is when the muscle is contracting, but actually lengthening. For those of you who lift weights, this is seen as when doing a negative lift. For those of you who do combat sports, this might be seen when resisting a submission, like an armbar. The attacker is doing their best to straighten the arm, but the person being attacked is contracting their biceps to prevent the arm from straightening. Eccentric loading is the type of contraction that puts the most stress on the muscle-tendon-bone relationship, and I have seen distal biceps ruptures as a result of defending an armbar. I've also seen it when people are throwing a hook in boxing and the arm is straight.
Oh no! Tore my bicep.
The distal biceps ruptures when the forces being put through the muscle exceed the tendon strength or tendon bone attachment. Things that can make someone susceptible to this injury is if the muscle gains strength faster than the other parts of the chain, or if chronic injury or tendonitis weakens the tendon and or its connection to the bone. Anabolic steroids can contribute to a few of these things, and smoking can contribute to weakening of tissues, but sometimes it just seems that wear and tear are the main underlying issue. As a brief aside, biceps tendon ruptures at the shoulder, proximal tears, are more common, usually happen in slightly older people, but these injuries are much less disabling as there are two proximal tendons, so the muscle can still do what it needs to do even with one ruptured. Does change the way things look, but many people can tolerate that fine. Whatever the underlying issue is, the tendon connection fails, usually at its insertion on the bone, but it could happen anywhere within the tendon or with its connection to the muscle. Often, patients will describe a pop in their elbow, followed by pain and a cramping sensation. Soon, bruising often develops around the elbow, and then there will be the classic deformity of the arm near the elbow. Functionally, there is weakness in elbow flexion and supination. The amount of elbow flexion strength one can expect to lose is about 30%, and the amount of supination strength is up to 50%. I do want to note that the accompanying photos are from a professional triathlete who's had his ruptured biceps for 30 years. Didn't seem to slow him down much. All right, so the treatment. Non-operative management is always an option. However, the patient will be missing up to half their supination strength and almost a third of their elbow flexion strength. It'll also look different. For many people, this is not acceptable, and surgery is the option. Surgery is fairly straightforward in principle. The tendon usually has a volst off the bone, so you put it back down onto the bone and allow it to heal. This is done in various ways, most commonly with suture, that is either then connected to a button that is put on the opposite side of the bone, or anchors put into the bone, and or a screw that holds the tendon in place. This can be done through one incision in the front of the arm or a second incision on the back. Issues arise with inherent complexity of the elbow. There are lots of other structures, nerves, blood vessels, and then the elbow is just a goofy joint. With surgery, most get back to their normal function and appearance, other than having a surgical scar. Postoperatively, most surgeons will allow for early range of motion of the elbow. Elbows like getting stiff, but limit lifting and pushing and pulling with the arm for at least 6 weeks. It then takes several months to get back to normal strength and function. Physical therapy is a big part of the recovery. I usually tell people to plan on 6 months of noticing that their arm is different, but allow normal activities at 3 months after surgery. This usually means, for a high-level athlete, that the earliest they are going to be in fight shape and ready to go is 6 to 8 months after injury. Be safe, have fun, get after it. Most importantly, let's keep moving.